Welcome to The Catch-Up. My name is Damon Blake. You are watching a video podcast hosted by two Irish comedians who are also best friends. One is in Ireland, one is in Scotland. And each week we come here onto the YouTubes to talk to each other and to our very funny friends from around the world to see how lockdown, life, and all the little things that kind of get to us are treating us. This week, like last week, and potentially next week again, I am joined by my fabulous co-host, Mr. George Fox.
All right. That's the excitement I bring to this show. How are you, Damon?
I'm great. I've never been healthier. How are you doing, George?
I am very sick. I'm feeling a bit rough, you know, sinuses and stuff. But, you know, you've had this recently as well. So we have like a weird twin effect where when you're sick, a week later it hits me.
Well, I think at the end of the day, though, I live a very good, pure life, and you are a decadent monster. And so this is really just karma coming down to take you into the body that you deserve, but never have had to live with.
This is because I told you I ate those Oreo cookies I found on the street, isn't it?
Yeah. You knew I wanted them, and you took them, and this is where we are.
Well...
George, what are we doing this week?
Damon, we are having what we have in most weeks, which is a wonderful, wonderful guest. So if you're a fan of Try, you're going to recognize this person. If you're a fan of Irish YouTube, you'll also recognize this person. She's fantastically funny. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the show. Here's Kelly!
Woo!
Kelly, perfect. Perfect energy.
I'll bring it up. Good.
Nobody ever matches my energy, and that's appropriate. If anyone ever did, I would shut the show down immediately. I'm like,
nobody
done.
Can be as good as me. That's all it can be.
Kelly, thank you for lowering both the energy and your morals to talk to us today. It's been a long time since we were able to be in person. So I guess we're asking the question that is always asked during these things, which is, how have you been?
I've consistently been... grand, you know, that's what I'm aiming for. Anything else is a plus. So
Kelly, I want to sign you up to a therapist just so you can go in and he's like, all right, what's going on? You're like, well, I've been consistently grand for 25 years, but
but I feel like I genuinely would go into a therapist and they'd be like, so tell me all your problems. And I'm like, oh, I don't want to be a bother, you know, it's, it's fine, I'll just sort them myself, you know.
Kelly, so. You have the opposite of my concerns and worry. My worry is I'll go into a therapist and be like, I don't know, I had a dream last night that I ate some Oreos I found in the street, and the guy would be like, that's a sign for a serial killer, everyone knows that.
No, I think they would think I was a sociopath just because I'd be like, no, they're definitely trying to get inside information. They've been paid by someone to take all my information, so they're not getting any of it.
Very interesting point of view on it, Kelly, because I do believe at the moment you've gotten very interested in the subject of cybersecurity.
Currently completing my master's. I started in September in cybersecurity. And since then, I have panicked about the internet every day.
Oh.
Okay, can you tell us, what is cybersecurity broadly?
I mean, I guess it's kind of, you know, how you're protected, how companies are protected, kind of, and then it goes into, you know, how people are attacked, what you can do to stay safe, kind of all these things. Like, my course is actually very good because here's how to do all the bad things. Here it is. Here's how you do it. Oh, and now that we thought you had to do the bad things, here's how you protect from doing the bad things. I'll give you an example of that. Was we had a class last week where we went onto the dark web. So he was like, oh, here's the dark web. And everybody follow along. Everybody, you know, get onto the dark web. And then at the end of the class, he went, by the way, you're definitely on a government list now. Warning would have been fantastic. Thank you so much.
So you learned from that session to also just never trust anybody in authority, because at the end of the day, they will just get you into trouble.
Yeah, I take classes, obviously. And then after the classes, I take an hour break to go, oh God, the internet. Oh God, can I just remove myself from the internet? Like...
is there a thing such as un-Googling yourself?
I watched a documentary recently about the Sony hack and about cybersecurity, and it made me very scared as well. I mean, as somebody who has a bit more education on this, how screwed are we in terms of global cybersecurity?
Depends on how much you value your security.
Not at all.
If you're okay with the government, like, having your information, well, then you're A-okay. But if you're one of these people that think the government are going to track you by, like, the vaccine or anything like that,
Yes.
They're already tracking you. They already know where you are.
Oh,
like,
oh no.
It's not a, yeah.
That's kind of comforting in a way to know that they care for you enough to know where you always are. If I was able to pay you, would you be able to hack into George's email address?
Now, I won't tell George this, but the problem is staying out of George's email. Because got some stuff in there, you know, he's into some weird shit. So
it's true.
Oh, well, no one's surprised by that. If you went in not thinking that, you're the fool.
Kelly, what are some things that people can do to lock down their internet usage and protect themselves from the cyber pirates that are surfing the cyber seas?
Lots of things that you wouldn't even consider. Obviously, the big one is don't have the same password for everything. I recommend people getting a password vault. Don't know if you've known what they are, but you can have one password, which you remember, which is real long, and then you put that into the vault and it'll give you the rest of your password. You got to keep your passwords long. They don't even need to have a lot of characters and numbers. They just need to be really, really long so that they can't
see. L-O-L-O-N-G.
Yeah. No, R-E-A-L-L-Y-L-O-N-G.
1, 2, 3. That's a very strong password.
Really strong.
1, 2, 3 is not even needed, you know?
Great.
So if you were, Kelly, to give me and Damon a password, what would you suggest?
Which we will use.
Which we will use.
We will use it.
What would you suggest?
Yeah. I would suggest watch the catch-up with Damon and George.
Okay.
Do I get brownie points for that? Look, it's long enough, I think.
I think we could shorten it just a little. Just by then. Just a few letters. Maybe just watch the catch-up with George and that's it.
There you go.
One thing I do is, Kelly, whenever I sign up to a new mailing list, when it asks me my name, I always put asshole so that whenever they spam email me, it goes, hey, asshole. And then I know that it's not actually a friend of mine getting in contact.
People have said this, right? People have said that they put their name and then they put the company that they're putting their mailing list to. So that if you get a spam mail from a company that you don't remember, the company that sold your data is going to be in the mail.
Oh, very good.
That is such a good idea. I love this. We've gone full Columbo with this, Kelly. Oh, I like this.
Yeah.
I use two-factor authentication for all of my accounts. Whenever I put in my password, I then have to go to the post office to show ID to prove that it's actually myself. Is there anything else you would recommend to people that they do?
Don't trust anybody on the internet.
I don't believe you.
Nice try, internet.
This isn't even Kelly. This is some sort of AI bot trying to trick us.
If I was smart enough to create an AI bot that was me, No, I mean, have you ever seen... I know it sounds silly, but I think people forget how frequently everybody can see their data on the internet. Like, do you remember those 5Ks that everybody was doing at one point or another because everybody was, like, tagging them? People kept putting up their runs. Like, being like, I did my 5K run, and I'm like... Great, I've just figured out exactly where you live.
It's why I don't run.
Yeah, that's the problem.
Cybersecurity, keeping it safe.
Yeah, absolutely. Regular security, keeping it safe.
Well, Kelly, thank you so much for giving us the down low on the binary of the internet cybersecurity. We very much appreciate it because we are two stupid men who are constantly replying to every email we get with our bank passwords. So thank you for giving us a little bit of education today. Is there anything else you've got going on in the real world, the meat space?
Not a single thing that I could think of.
Nothing springs to mind. Nothing like some, maybe they have merch or like that you can buy a nice turquoise hoodie with the brand name on it. Anything like that at all?
Oh, maybe you should, if you don't, you should go subscribe to Try.
Okay,
they're good. So.
They are good and they promise to never misuse any of the data that they receive.
Never. Jokes on them, we don't even receive any data. So
great, I think. Yeah. If you don't want to mishandle it, just never get your hands on it.
You can't mishandle something you don't have.
Kelly, well, this has been such a great time to catch up with you and find out everything about the internet. Thank you for joining myself and George. We look forward to seeing you in the future when we're both healthier in our bodies and in our internet browsers.
Thanks so much for having me. Great fun. Love talking about security and scaring everyone on the internet.
We hope that everybody here is locked down both physically and on their computers. And if you've enjoyed the video, please like and leave a comment. That would be ace.
Thanks very much for watching. Thanks, Kelly, for being the one to these two zeros. We really appreciate it. We really hope that you guys out there are definitely going to try and use the password MeetSpace in the future. But thanks very much for joining us for this week. Kelly, thank you. Damon, we'll see you next week when I'm healthier. And everybody else, we'll see you next week on the Catch Up.
Bye.